Welcome to the online classes from Dhaka Secondary School, North Karachi campus. Assalamu alaikum, students of Pakistan Studies of Class 10 in the session of 2021 and 2022. We are studying our syllabus for the month of August, week 2 and chapter 1, Ideological Basis of Pakistan is going on. I am your teacher, Miss Uzma. Topics we are going to cover are Principles of Democracy in Islam, Statements of Allama Iqbal for the Ideology of Pakistan, Statements of Qaid-e-Azam for the Ideology of Pakistan, and Ideology and National Character. Principles of Democracy in Islam, Justice. This is the first principle of democracy in Islam, which means to keep the right thing at their right places. It is a foundation of divine law. It is justice which makes any society peaceful and prosperous. Thus, Holy Quran emphasized upon establishment of justice. The fundamental rights of the individuals are protected in the judicial system of Islam. Number two, equality. Islam is the torchbearer of equality. Among the human beings, Islam rejects all kinds of discrimination on the basis of race, language, caste, color, culture, and wealth or poverty. Number three, fraternity. It means brotherhood. In the words of Holy Quran, all believers are brother to each other. The feelings of brotherhood promote affection, mutual cooperation, selfless service, and sacrifices. In this way, the society becomes peaceful and a place of comfort for all. Islam does not allow conspiracy or ill will even towards non-Muslims. And the last one is tolerance. Tolerance is a great virtue. It saves people from hardship and promotes love for others. The best way to develop social relations is to spread tolerance. Holy Prophet ﷺ preached tolerance through his words and deeds. The Islamic society honors and protects the due rights of the non-Muslims. Statements of Allama Iqbal for the Ideology of Pakistan. Address of Allahabad, 1930, he explained the idea of the separate nationhood for the Muslim. That India is a subcontinent and not a country, where people belonging to different religions and speaking different languages are inhabited. Muslim nations has its unique religious and cultural identity. All civilized nations should respect religious principles, cultural and social values of Muslims. He further said, I would like to see the Punjab, the Northwest Frontier Province, Sindh and Balochistan amalgamated into a single state. Formation of a consolidated Northwest Muslim state appears to be the final destiny of the Muslims, at least of Northwest India. Now, the statements of Qaid-e-Azam for the Ideology of Pakistan. Qaid-e-Azam was a form advocate of two-nation theory, which becomes the ideological basis of Pakistan. He said the Muslims are a nation by every right to establish their separate homeland. They can adopt any means to promote and protect their economic, social, political and cultural interests. On 23rd March 1940, at the historic session of the Muslim League Lahore, he said, the Muslims are not a minority. They are nation by any definition. By all canons of international law, we are a nation. In his presidential address at the annual session of Muslim League at Lahore in 1940, he said, India is not a nation nor a country. It is a subcontinent of nationalities, Hindus and Muslims being the two major nations. The Hindus and Muslims belong to two different religions, philosophies, social customs and literature. They neither intermarry nor interdine, and they belong to two different civilizations which are based mainly on conflicting ideas and conceptions. Their aspects on life and of are different. It is quite clear that Hindus and Muslims derive their inspiration from different sources of history. On March 8, 1944, while addressing the students of Muslim University, he said, "Hindus and Muslims, though living in the same town and villages, had never been blended into one nation. They were always two separate entities." Address at Islamia College, Peshawar, in 1946, at Islamia College, Qaid-e-Azam address, "We do not demand Pakistan simply to have a piece of land, but we want a laboratory where we could experiment on Islamic principles." Address on 18th June 1945, in his message to the Frontier Muslim Students Federation, he said, "Pakistan not only means freedom and independence, but Muslims' ideology, which has to be preserved, which came to us as a precious gift and treasure, and which we hope others will share with us." Ideology and national character. Character is the sum total of habits, attitudes, and the way of living of an individual. The following elements shape the national character. In this, number one, firm belief in the ideology. A firm belief in the ideology contributes positively towards the development Muslim character into nationalist spirit, and his or her action shall not be directed towards national interest. Our ideology stems from Islam, therefore we should build our character in the light of Islamic values. Number two, commitment. Commitment means devotion with a sense of duty and responsibility. A person who acts and in conformity with the national ideology fully devotes himself or herself to the cause of the nation. Number three, honesty. Honesty is a virtue recognized in all societies. Honesty should be visible in all fields of life. Islam has emphasized upon honesty in very strong words. Number four, patriotism. Patriotism is an eternal virtue. It is an expression of the love and sacrifice for one's country. Individuals reflect their best national character at the time of the test and or when their freedom is endangered. Number five, hard work. Nations progress when their individuals work hard. This requires sense of duty, commitment to work, and honest performance. The developed and advanced nations have become prosperous because of their hard work. Number six, the last one, national interest. The personal character of an individual must reflect the supremacy of national interest and with no compromise on it. It is here that the virtues like honesty, dedication, and commitment and their articulation. Only those nations survive whose individuals do not compromise on their national interest. Questions are in front of you. Complete your work. Thank you.